डियर स्टूडेंट्स, फोर्थ पार्ट, फोर्थ क्वेश्चन, वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. डू द थर्ड पार्ट योर सेल्फ, इट विल बी वेरी इजी. नाउ द टैक्सी चार्जेस इन अ सिटी कंसिस्ट ऑफ अ फिक्स्ड चार्ज टुगेदर विद द चार्ज ऑफ द डिस्टेंस कवर्ड. फॉर अ डिस्टेंस ऑफ 10 किलोमीटर द चार्ज पेड इज दिस, एंड फॉर अ जर्नी ऑफ 15 किलोमीटर द चार्ज पेड इज 155 रुपीज. What are the fixed charges and charges per kilometer? Dear students, whatever is the question, that is the starting of our answer. So let the fixed charges be X rupees and charges per kilometer be Y rupees. As I taught you in 9th class also, dear students, if you remember the taxi fare question in 4th chapter, I taught you at that time that for the first kilometer, for the fixed charges do not depend on the distance, okay? So, and the charges per kilometer will depend upon the distance. So what they have given to us, that for the first cases, fixed charges fixed, no multiplication, plus they have traveled 10 kilometers and per kilometer the cost is y, therefore the cost of 10 kilometers will be 10y and the total amount paid is rupees 105. In second case, again the fixed charges will be fixed. No, they do not depend on the kilometers traveled. They traveled for 15 kilometers, so 15y is equal to total amount paid for 15 kilometers is 155. Dear students, in this way you will get the two equations, right? So now, as we have to use the substitution method in this exercise, so you all know how to solve. Get the value of x from any one equation and then put in the second one. So you will get the value of xy. So dear students, this is the substitution method. I have solved it for you. Take out the value from first equation. You will get x is equal to 105 minus 10y. Put in second, get the value of y. Then by putting the value of y in third equation, you will get the value of 5. So the answer is, therefore, fixed charges is equal to 5 rupees and charges per kilometer is equal to 10 rupees. Now one more part is there in this question, dear students. How much does a person have to pay for traveling a distance of 25 kilometer? Now we have to tell if a person travels for 25 kilometer, how much he has to pay. So for 25 kilometer, amount to be paid is equal to fixed charges 5 rupees, right, plus 25 kilometers the man has to travel, and per kilometer 10 rupees, so we will multiply it by 10. So 5 plus 250, that means for 25 kilometer a man has to pay 255 rupees, right? Fixed charges are not going to be multiplied by the kilometers, okay? So in this way you can calculate the question. Now next question. A fraction becomes 9/11. Means now they are talking about a fraction. If 2 is added to both the numerator and denominator, second full stop. If 3 is added to both numerator and denominator, it becomes 5/6. Find the fraction. So whenever, dear students, whenever they'll ask you about the fraction, and if numerator and denominators are mentioned in the question, always start from the fraction. So what you have to take is, to make a fraction you need a numerator and a denominator, obviously. So let us first assume that the numerator is equal to x and denominator is equal to y. Obviously the fraction is equal to x by y. Now in the question it is given that it means the fraction. It becomes, for becomes equal to, it becomes 9/11, right? It means fraction, becomes equal to 9 by 11 if 2 is added to both the numerator and denominator. When does it become 9 by 11? When we add 2 on to both numerator and denominator. In second line, dear students, what they said, if we add 3 to both numerator and denominator, then the fraction becomes 5 by 6. When we add 2 to both, the fraction becomes 9 by 11. When we add 3 to both, the fraction becomes 5 by 6. Now, these are not in the general form of linear equations. So first we will convert them in general form that you have learnt in your 8th class. You have learnt this kind of equations in your 8th class, how to convert them in linear form. Just cross multiply them. 11 multiplied by x plus 2 is equal to 9 multiplied this. Then convert it into xy equation. Similarly here, by cross multiplying, get the two equations. Then solve them by substitution method. Dear students, do this question yourself. And at the end, you will get the value of x and y. Then the fraction becomes x by y. Okay? So, dear students, in this way, by cross multiplication, 11 multiplied by x plus 2, 9 multiply this. After solving it, you will get this equation. Then, similarly here, if you will take 6 multiplied by x plus 3, 5 multiplied by y plus 3, you will get this equation. Now, substitution method. From first, I have taken out the value of x. 11x is equal to minus 4 plus 9y. Then 11 is multiplied. It will goes in the denominator. Put the equation 3 in 2 because we have used 1. So, when you put it, you will get a fraction. Distributive property, minus 24 plus 54. I have taken the LCM also, 11 5s are 55. Then I have done the cross multiplication also in the same step, 3 11s are 33. Okay, dear students, do not get confused. So now next, after solving it, you will get the value of y. Then by putting the value of y in third equation, you will get the value of x. So the answer is, because they asked us about the fraction, therefore the fraction is 7 by 9. So dear students, in this way you will be able to solve the questions yourself.